हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डेड एम। तो आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत अच्छे से चल रहा होगा बिकॉज प्रीलिम्स इज वेरी नियर। होप योर रिवीजन इज गोइंग एट अ रैपिड पेस बिकॉज एट दिस स्टेज रिवीजन इज वेरी की। सो हियर वी आर हेल्पिंग यू विद द प्रीलिम्स रैपिड रिवीजन सीरीज। तो इस लेक्चर सीरीज में हम ज्योग्राफी के लास्ट वन एंड हाफ ईयर करंट अफेयर्स कवर कर रहे हैं। तो प्रीवियस लेक्चर में पार्ट वन में हमने देखा जियोमॉर्फोलॉजी और ओशनोग्राफी के रिलेटेड करंट अफेयर्स। तो इस लेक्चर में हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं ओशनोग्राफी से विल कंटिन्यू विद द ओशनोग्राफी एंड वी विल सी सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल टाइस, डिस्प्यूट्स एंड वेरियस वाटर बॉडी रिलेटेड करंट इश्यूज। ठीक है, तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट, द चागोस आइलैंड्स वॉज इन यूज। वाई इट वॉज इन यूज? बिकॉज मॉरिशियस claims Chagos Islands, but it is currently with United Kingdom. UK, previously when it was ruling the Indian subcontinent, Mauritius and Maldives, all these countries, it has held the Chagos Islands in the Indian Ocean archipelago along with it. The UK has given the islands, has given this Chagos Islands to America for its naval base. Now, Mauritius has been to international court and the international court has given a judgment for UK to vacate this island and give it back to Mauritius. But United Kingdom still has not given it. United Kingdom and US has expressed their reservations with regarding to this judgment. And Mauritius calls UK an illegal colonial occupier after it ignored the UN mandated deadline to return the Chagos Islands, which is, as I told, a small archipelago in the Indian Ocean region. So archipelago means the island, or you can say the island series, which are made up of the corals. They are made up of the corals, which is calcium carbonate. That is about the Chagos Islands. Next, the Dangle Depression. The Dangle Depression is that depression between Africa and the Europe. It is the end of the Great African Rift Valley towards the north of the Africa. Okay, this is between Africa and Europe. This Dangle Depression, recently the study found out that life cannot survive in this depression. What is the reason? The reason is, this depression is because earlier a water body used to exist and this water body evaporated because of the heat. When this water body evaporated, it left a lot of salt deposits in this region. So these salt deposits is making sure, or because of this salt deposits, life cannot exist in this region. So because of these salt deposits, life cannot exist in this region. So that is the reason this was in news. Okay, so recently they have identified two barriers. The first is the magnesium dominated brines. As I told, this is because of the earlier existed water body. Okay, and this has very low pH, that means it is very acidic, which is not conducive for the organisms to survive. Okay, that is the reason this was in use. So Dangle Depression is in Africa towards the end of the Great Rift Valley. It is between Africa and Europe. Next one, Cyclone Bulbul. Cyclone Bulbul occurred in the Indian Ocean. This name is given by Pakistan. This name is contributed by Pakistan. So there are a lot of cyclones that occurred in the Indian Ocean region. You have to know these cyclones because a question might be asked, which cyclone occurred in which region? So that kind of question can be asked. So इसीलिए हमें बहुत ज़रूरी है जानना है कि किस cyclone कौन से region में occur है। तो previously lecture 1 में हमने देखा the different cyclones that occurred in the Arabian Sea and the Japanese Sea. So here we will see some more. The cyclone Pabuk, it occurred in the South China Sea. Cyclone Pabuk occurred in the South China Sea. Cyclone Fani occurred in the Bay of Bengal. Cyclone Vayu occurred in the Arabian Sea. Cyclone Hika, we have seen previously, it occurred in the Arabian Sea, and this cyclone has affected countries like Oman, Iran and the other countries in that region. And Cyclone Maha also occurred in Arabian Sea along with Cyclone Kyar. Cyclone Kyar is also a super cyclone that affected countries around the Oman region. Okay, next one, Madden-Julian Oscillation, MJBO. What is this Madden-Julian Oscillation? It is a wave, MGO wave. It is a global band of low pressure area. It's a band of low pressure area that moves periodically. That means it moves west and east. It generally moves periodically from west to east. Remember the direction west to east. okay, and it determines the initiation and intensity of low pressure areas. The low pressure areas are those areas where generally cyclones originate, and also the low pressure areas determine the conditions, the weather patterns, the wind movements, everything. So that is why it is important for us to study about these low pressure areas. Okay, so Madden-Julian oscillation is that oscillation which determines the periodical movement of winds from west to east, low pressure winds especially. Okay, next one, Drake Passage was in use. What is this Drake Passage? Drake Passage is that narrow stretch of water that is there in between South America and Antarctica. This narrow passage which is there in between the South America and the Antarctic islands, this is the nearest, or you can say this is the narrowest passage between landmass and Antarctica. It is a body of water between South America's Cape Horn. You can see this is South America's Cape Horn in this map. You can see here. Okay, you can see in this map. So, and here in the south you have the South Shetland Island of Antarctica. So Drake Passage is that narrow passage between this South America and Antarctica. This is the shortest crossing from Antarctica to any landmass. Okay, that is Drake Passage. Next, Taal Volcano. Taal Volcano occurred on the island of Luzon in Philippines. Luzon in Philippines. Taal Volcano, Philippines. It's a complex volcano. Now, what is a complex volcano? A complex volcano is a compound volcano. That means it has more than two vents, two or more vents. Normally, a volcano has a single hill and a single vent. But this complex volcano has multiple vents. Okay, that is why this was in use. So Taal Volcano, which is a complex volcano, it is there in the island of Luzon in Philippines. Next, Mount Aconcagua. Mount Aconcagua was in use. Why it was in use? It was in use because recently a 12-year-old Mumbai student, Kamya Karthikeya, he has climbed this student from Mumbai, he has climbed this Mount Aconcagua. So where is this Mount Aconcagua located? It is the highest peak of the Andes Mountains in Argentina, South America. So it is the highest peak in the South American region in the Andes. So Andes, remember where it is? It is in South America. This mountain is important because it is one of the so-called seven summits of the seven continents. So seven summits, the seven continents have seven summits. That means each continent has a single summit. For Asia, it is Mount Everest. In that way, the South America, it is the Mount Aconcagua. Mount Aconcagua climbed by Indian student Kamya Karthikeya. He is the youngest in the world to summit this mountain. Next, Rohtang Pass. Rohtang Pass is located in Himachal Pradesh. Rohtang Pass is located in Himachal Pradesh. There is another news about the Rohtang Tunnel that is there in Jammu and Kashmir. Rohtang Tunnel in Jammu and Kashmir. This Rohtang Tunnel is going to be renamed after our former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. Okay, the Rohtang Pass located on the eastern Pir Panjal range of Himalayas. Located on eastern Pir Panjal range of the Himalayas. Next one, about the summer solstice. Summer solstice and winter solstice. Summer solstice means the rays of the sun fall directly over the Tropic of Cancer. Over the Tropic of Cancer, that is in the northern hemisphere. Okay, so what happens on this summer solstice? Summer solstice, the day will be long. There will be a long day in the northern hemisphere. So June 21 is that day. It marks the beginning of the end of summer season in the northern hemisphere. Okay, so June 21 is the longest day of the year, and it is the summer solstice in northern hemisphere. And December 22, where the sun rays fall directly over Tropic of Capricorn. Over the Tropic of Capricorn. As you know, the earth is tilted. This is the axis of the earth. So what will happen? The sun rays falls at an angle, and it will not fall directly over any region continuously throughout the year. It will fall directly only for a specified time. Okay, because of that, you will have the variation in the weather patterns. So December 22, winter solstice. June 21, summer solstice. Next one, Chilai Kalan. What is Chilai Kalan? It is the 40-day harshest winter period in Kashmir. Chilai Kalan is 40-day harshest winter period in Kashmir. Remember, Chilai Kalan. Okay, Chilai Kalan in Kashmir. So these 40 days are the days where the chances of snowfall is very high and the temperature reaches the lowest in these 40 days only. That is Chilaikkalan. Next one, Sithve Port. Sithve Port was in news. Why it was in news? Because Sithve Port is that port which India is developing for its Kaladan multimodal project. So Kaladan multimodal project is that project of India where India intends to connect the northeastern region through Myanmar. Connecting northeastern through Myanmar. So from Kolkata, India will go to Sithve Port. From Sithve Port, through land route, it will connect Myanmar. Sorry, it will connect the northeast, Mizoram, Aizwal, you can see here. Okay. So the Sithve Port is the capital of Rakhine State in southwestern Myanmar. So Rakhine State is that state where the Rohingyas also exist. So that is important for you. So Sithve Port is in Rakhine State. It is located at the mouth of Kaladan River, which flows into Mizoram in northeastern India. So there is a river called Kaladan River. So that is why we call this Kaladan multimodal project, because even in this Kaladan River, we are developing a waterway. So to an extent, there will be waterway. From there, we will have the land route to the state of Mizoram. Okay. That is why this is important. Next, maritime route between Chennai and Vladivostok was in news. Recently, our Prime Minister went to Russia. When he went to Russia, he made a deal where India is going to invest in the Far East region of Russia. So if a question is asked, where is the Far East region located? The Far East region is the region in Russia. So this Far East region is very sparsely populated region of Russia. But this region is very rich in natural resources. So Russia wants investment in this region. And recently when our Prime Minister visited Russia, so he has made a pledge to invest in the Far East region of Russia. And we are also talking about a connectivity between Chennai and Vladivostok. Vladivostok is in the Far East region of Russia. So normally, in the current scenario, if you want to go to Russia, we have to go all the way crossing Europe and reach Russia, Moscow. But now we can reach Russia if we make sure this connectivity exists, or if we can develop this connectivity route, we can directly go to Russia through the other side, that is through the South China Sea. We can go to Russia, to the Far East region. Next one, Kalapani was in news. Why it was in news? Because recently we have seen clashes between India and Nepal, the diplomatic clashes, you can say. Nepal has accused India of unilaterally occupying their territory. According to India, Kalapani is territory of India, but according to Nepal, Kalapani is their territory. Okay, there is a border dispute between India and Nepal with regarding to this. India, after its abrogation of Article 370, has released a new map. In this new map, India has shown Kalapani in its map. That is when Nepal got triggered and they have issued statements with regarding to this. So India included Kalapani into the Pitorgarh district of Uttarakhand. But Nepal government says that Kalapani is an integral part of Nepal and it is an unresolved area. Next one, Mangdechu Hydro Project. Mangdechu Hydro Project, where it is located? It is located in Bhutan. Mangdechu River is in Bhutan and it is over this river Mangdechu Hydro Project is developed. It is one of the 10 hydro projects planned under the Royal Government of Bhutan's initiative to generate 10,000 megawatts of hydro power by 2020 with the support of India. India is helping Bhutan in developing these hydro projects. So Mangdechu Hydro Project is in Bhutan. Next, zero budget natural farming was in news. So recently, Andhra Pradesh government has signed an MOU with a German firm, KFW, regarding zero budget natural farming. What is this zero budget natural farming? Zero budget natural farming is the method of farming where, using less investment, using the traditional methods of agriculture, we are going to develop, we are going to grow crops. Okay, so all the natural fertilizers will be used and all the natural techniques will be used. Farmers will use earthworm, cow dung, cow urine, plants, human excreta and such biological fertilizers for the crop protection and not the artificial fertilizers. As it is said that the zero budget natural farming requires only 10% of water and 10% of electricity than that of what we are using in the modern agriculture. So 10% is very less. So this is a very advantageous type of farming for us. It's a modern method of farming using the traditional approaches. Next one, Feni River was in use. Feni River is the river between India and Bangladesh. Remember, Feni between India and Bangladesh. So recently there was an MOU where India will withdraw 1.82 cubic of water from Feni River for the drinking water supply and other things that are required for Tripura. The Feni River originates in South Tripura and it flows to Bangladesh. So Bangladesh is a lower riparian country with regard to this Feni River. It's a transboundary river with an ongoing dispute about the water rights. So Feni River is between India and Bangladesh, remember that, in Tripura. Next, Mekong River. Mekong River water levels fell as a new Laos dam has been built. Okay, this Mekong River originates in Tibet and it flows through China, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia and Vietnam. There is a corporation, Mekong Ganga Corporation. This is between India, Myanmar. Okay, so this is between basically the countries where Ganga flows and the Mekong flows. It is between India, Myanmar, Thailand, Cambodia. Okay, I don't think you can see the map. Now you can see this. Okay, the Mekong Ganga Corporation is between India, Myanmar, Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 countries. Remember, 6. India, Myanmar, Thailand, Cambodia, Laos and Vietnam. So these are the countries where Mekong River flows and Ganga flows in India. So Mekong Ganga Cooperation. Next, Victoria Falls was in use. Where is Victoria Falls? It is located in Africa. Victoria Falls is located in Africa, remember that. These are the falls fed by Zambezi River and it defines the boundary between Zambia and Zimbabwe. Victoria Falls defines the boundary between Zambia and Zimbabwe. The falls also referred as the smoke that thunders and it is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The smoke that thunders, you know, Victoria Falls. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, okay. Now let's revise what we have studied till now. Okay, first we have seen about Chagos Island. Chagos Island is located in the Indian Ocean and it is claimed by Mauritius and currently it is under UK. Next one, Danic Depression. Danic Depression is located in Africa, in the north of Africa. It is between Africa and Europe, we can say that. Next one, Cyclone Bulbul. Cyclone Bulbul was in use because it occurred in the Indian Ocean region and the name is contributed by Pakistan. There are various other cyclones that occurred in the Indian Ocean region, like the Cyclone Pabuk, Cyclone Fani, Cyclone Hika, Cyclone Vayu, Cyclone Kyar and Cyclone Maha. Just pause and go through these cyclones. We have already talked about that. Next, Madden-Julian Oscillation. So Madden-Julian Oscillation is that oscillation of a low pressure area from west to east. Low pressure area from west to east. Okay. Next one, Drake Passage. It is the narrow passage between South America and Antarctica. It is a narrow passage between South America and Antarctica. Next, Taal Volcano. Taal Volcano is located in Luzon in Philippines. Luzon in Philippines. It's a complex volcano. Okay. Next one, Mount Aconcagua. Mount Aconcagua is in South America. It is the highest peak of South America in the Andes in Argentina. Okay. This is in use because Indian student Kamya Karthikeya, he has climbed this Mount Aconcagua. Next one, Rohtang Pass. Rohtang Pass in Himachal Pradesh. Next one, summer solstice. Summer solstice occurs on June 21 and winter solstice occurs on December 22nd. Next one, Chilai Kalan. Chilai Kalan is the 40-day harvest period in Kashmir. Next, Sitwe Port is in Myanmar. Next, maritime route between Chennai and Vladivostok. Vladivostok is located in the far east region of Russia. Next, Kalapani Territory. Kalapani Territory is the disputed territory between India and Nepal. Kalapani River, India claims, and Nepal also claims the Kalapani River. Next, Meghdechu Hydro Project. Meghdechu is hydro project is located in Bhutan on the Meghdechu River. Meghdechu River. Next one, zero budget natural farming. Andhra Pradesh government signed an MOU with German firm. Next, Feni River was in use. Feni River is the river between India and Bangladesh. It is a transboundary river. It is situated, the Feni River is in Tripura and the river flows from Tripura to Bangladesh. Next, Mekong River. Mekong River was in use and Mekong River flow originates in Tibet and it flows through China, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam. So you can see here, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam and India. These form part of the Mekong Ganga Cooperation. Mekong Ganga Cooperation. Next one, Victoria Falls was in use. Victoria Falls is located in Africa. Okay, it is between Zambia and Zimbabwe and the Victoria Falls is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Okay, so that's it, friends, in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.